To complete this project, you will need a wooden number 2 pencil and a cup of water. Everything else is included. Begin by removing the contents from the box and place them on the table. Unwrap the Canopic jar replica and place a sheet of craft paper in your lap. Fold the second sheet of craft paper and place the replica on top. Lay the two plates, paintbrush, and sponges on the paper. You will use the dark brown paint first. Squeeze some dark brown paint onto one side of the empty plate. Dampen one end of the textured sponge with clean water. Squeeze excess water onto the plate and mix with the paint to create a wash. Randomly dab the dark brown wash over the entire replica. Once complete, clean the textured sponge with water. Use the same technique with the blue paint. You can switch between the textured and white sponge to create unique designs. Once you're done, set the plate and sponges aside. Allow the replica to dry. Using the pencil, lightly sketch the designs you would like onto the replica. Place the top onto the jar and use the pencil to mark where the lines will match the top, as shown here. Draw the hieroglyphics you would like onto the front of the jar. There are hieroglyphic designs located in the lesson plan. If you make a mistake, you can erase the pencil lines. Squeeze a small amount of the black paint onto the second clean plate. Only a small amount of color is needed. Using the paintbrush, begin painting over your penciled lines and hieroglyphics. Lightly thinning the paint will help it flow better when painting thin lines. Once you are satisfied with your painting, clean the paintbrush thoroughly and save for future art projects. Allow the replica to dry thoroughly before handling or packing. If packing, use the clean paper in your lap to wrap the replica. You may need to tape the box if it is transported by small children. If you have any questions or comments, please do not hesitate to contact us. Thank you for using Art in History.